The new show from HBO, Watchmen, is out, and from what we've seen so far, we really enjoy it. However, one thing I've seen a lot of online have been a lot of complaints about the core narrative of the show having to deal with, and I quote, too much politics. Specifically, what people seem to be referring to here is the idea of white nationalism, race, and how it's represented in the show. Also, I think it's kind of worth noting that this isn't really Rorschach's 7th Cavalry. It's just, it didn't have the same ring for a video title as the 7th Cavalry, a group of people that base their ideology off somebody they've never met named Rorschach from the original Watchmen. That video would be just way too long of a title. Rorschach didn't start the group or partake in any of their activities. They came much later, but because of the fact that he is heavily used in their imagery, I wanted to title the video in a way that bonded the two together. Now, before we go any further, I just wanted to take a step back and say that if you're watching this show, Watchmen, and you're concerned that the show has too many political elements, specifically the elements of, you know, white nationalism and racism, then let me just say that this show is probably not for you. The original Watchmen is entirely political in its themes, and it does an excellent job of expressing those sentiments, whether you choose to agree with what Alan Moore was saying or not. However, if you aren't the type of person that can digest media that reflects some of the worst aspects of history and society back on us, then probably don't watch this show. When the show made its debut, one element of the plot that probably shocked many people was how the far-right conservative movement, and specifically a hate group named the 7th Cavalry, had adopted Rorschach to be their symbol of white nationalism. For people not entirely familiar with the comics, this might seem weird. Keep in mind the majority of people watching the show are probably coming into this with their only point of reference being the Zack Snyder adaptation. I'm going to try to do my best in this video to explain to you how the original comics set up the events of this world, specifically as they relate to Rorschach and his imagery being used as a symbol of white nationalism. One thing that's also incredibly important to point out is that there's a ton of supplemental material for the show out on the internet, with HBO releasing more and more by the week. This supplemental material is helping to flesh out the events that took place leading up to the show. Keep in mind the original Watchmen took place in 1985, and the show is taking place 34 years later in 2019, so the world has drastically changed and moved on. One element not clearly defined within Zack Snyder's films was the fact that Rorschach was a fairly right-leaning character, frequently mocking the comic universe's version of the Liberal Party. One piece of supplemental evidence that we've seen is a memo from the Anti-Vigilante Task Force, ran by Lori Blake, also previously known as the Silk Spectre. This memo, released alongside the show, indicates that after Rorschach's disappearance following his death at the hands of Dr. Manhattan, his apartment was searched and found to be full of far right-wing periodicals from a news outlet named The New Frontiersman. The memo reads, "Kovacs was also an avid reader of The New Frontiersman, an extreme right-tilt tabloid prone to yellow journalism and Red Scare paranoia, whose editor of the period, Hector Godfrey, was a ferocious supporter of masked vigilantes. A generous appraisal of Kovacs would say that he merely collected the periodical for its glowing coverage of his war on crime, but Godfrey was also a hideous racist. An example can be found in an editorial published prior to Kovacs' disappearance. Taking exception to a critic of masked vigilantes, until then a largely white male phenomenon, who compared them to a modern-day Ku Klux Klan, Godfrey proceeded to defend the KKK." Now, I don't want to spend too much time going over the final bit of the comics, but Rorschach ultimately dies in his confrontation with Ozymandias and Dr. Manhattan. Ozymandias had just destroyed a large portion of New York using a cloned squid telekinetic bomb, and the subsequent carnage and devastation ended the escalating arms race between the world's superpowers that was threatening to destroy everything on the planet. So we probably all pretty much know what happened here. Ozymandias committed these horrible acts, Dr. Manhattan was complicit in them, and he subsequently leaves Earth, and Rorschach is killed when he threatens to expose the plan. But Rorschach also manages to mail a copy of his journal to the aforementioned New Frontiersman, a far right-wing extremist political magazine. All of this information is really important to understand because it all ties into how the 7th Cavalry rose to be. One thing that I was really shocked to learn when the show began is how little the general public knew about the actual events that took place in Antarctica and New York. Except, the more I read about the subsequent 30 years, it all starts to click. The events of the show are probably far more likely than we realize. Media and news today has become a matter of opinion and less of fact. The entire concept of fake news has been expertly paralleled in Rorschach's journal, and let me explain why. The material that was released to the public was more than likely not entirely accurate. Instead, it was filtered through an organization that was known for yellow journalism, i.e. journalism that's biased through sensationalism or exaggeration. This is further evidenced by the same anti-vigilante task force memo that I mentioned before. A quote from this reads that in 1986, New Frontiersman published excerpts from a journal allegedly written by Mr. Kovacs filled with outrageous claims against Mr. Veit, including accusations of murder and intimidations, that he was responsible for both the DIE and Dr. Manhattan's exile from Earth. The journal was dismissed as either a hoax or the expression of mental illness, though it remains an object of fascination for fringe artists and anti-government extremists. So you can see that the New Frontiersman, because of the nature of their publication, was having the credibility of the journal dismissed. However, combine that with the overwhelming wealth of Ozymandias and the ability for him to control the liberal media and narrative, and you can see where Rorschach made a very calculated error. In fact, Ozymandias was even able to shift the narrative to suggest that Rorschach didn't even write the journal in the first place, stating, "The author of Rorschach's journal was clearly an individual who wholly and completely identified as Rorschach, a man who considered Walter Kovacs a mere disguise and his ink-blot mask his true face." This element is very important, and we're going to discuss that in just a second. However, despite the fact that the journal was mostly dismissed, it did live on. Not necessarily for the documentation of the events that took place in 1985, but because of the extreme disdain within the pages for Democrats. Far right-wing conspiracy theorists spent a good bit of time pining over the journal, attempting to make sense of it. Keep in mind, Rorschach wrote in a very erratic way. He scribbled things, often didn't make sense, but the journal made sense to him, where it might not necessarily make sense to other people. The anti-vigilante task force memo mentions, "Relevant passages are thick with tangents, bitter rants about moral relativism and urban decay, and seething hate for liberals and intellectuals and smooth talkers." The Journal of Rorschach over time became a romanticized piece of literature, specifically amongst white power movements, much like The Birth of the Nation attempted to present the KKK as national heroes. The same memo states that from the ideals of this journal, the 7th Cavalry out of Tulsa, Oklahoma was born. The 7th Cavalry is also spelled with a K in part to pay homage to white nationalist movement the KKK. We mentioned earlier that Ozymandias started the narrative that Rorschach didn't even write the journal, instead it was just someone wearing his mask. Where the Klan used white robes and hoods, the 7th Cavalry have adopted and crudely created Rorschach masks. They turned Rorschach's costume into an entity of fear. Now, the show has gone on to explain us what the most significant, I guess you could call it an accomplishment, that the 7th Cavalry ever did was, and that is the White Knight. The White Knight is a fairly on-the-nose name for Christmas Eve in 2016 when members of the 7th Cavalry attacked and killed hundreds of police officers and their families within the Tulsa area. More about this will ultimately be revealed at a later time, so I won't claim to know much more about that, but I do have a good bit of theories about who was behind the 7th Cavalry and why the White Knight took place, and I'm sure that you will see another video about that in the future. But it does certainly paint the 7th Cavalry as a highly feared domestic terrorist organization that has the capacity to enact truly devastating plans. It makes sense that the characters of the show would be concerned that these terrorist cells are reforming. So that's a pretty crude explanation of the rise to prominence of the 7th Cavalry and why they idolize Rorschach so much. Personally, I think that Rorschach would probably have beat most of these people to death if given the chance, but it's certainly an interesting example of how something can be so widely misinterpreted over a very long period of time that it's almost unrecognizable when it rears its ugly head in the future. Thank you guys for watching this video. This has been Nick with Key Issues, and remember the motto, comics over everything.